Oh, are we rolling? Are we rolling? Okay, what's up, guys? Welcome to a new video. Now, this video is going to be a little bit different. So,
if you knew we were rolling because you looked right at the camera, bro. Anyway,
dang, man, you messed up my mojo. But anyways, if you couldn't tell by the video's title, this video is going to be about how to bench press. I'm going to teach you guys how to bench press like a powerlifter, the mental cues, the physical cues, and all the cues that you need in order to get your bench press effective and efficient. So the first thing we need to focus on is the base of everything. Basically, you need to focus on your foot placement whenever it comes to benching. A lot of people have their feet like everywhere, like they go like, I've seen people bench like this, and they'll be benching like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, it'd be everywhere, man. The feet be crazy. What you gotta make sure you're focused on is you gotta get a solid foundation. So, what you kinda wanna do is push your feet back as much as you possibly can. So, you get it right here. And I compete in the USAPL, so I have to make sure that my feet are flat-footed. So, like, my heel and my toes are touching the floor at the same time. So, I'm gonna push my feet back as far as possible, so I'm able to arch my back a lot easier. So, this is as far as it's gonna go comfortably without my feet completely coming off the ground. Come and start right here. And this allows me to get a strong base and keep my back arched as I'm benching. You zoomed into my face right now?
Yeah.
Damn. Okay, all right, so the next step when it comes to benching like a powerlifter is arching your back. So let me say this. It's not necessary to arch your back, but for powerlifting purposes, it reduces the range of motion. So if your back is arched like this, can you bring your chest out more and you don't have to come as far down and then come back up? So, you know, bodybuilders, you don't have to arch your back. You really don't. It's all dependent on you, but arching your back helps you stay tight with your back and helps you put your shoulder blades back together. So I'm gonna show you guys what it looks like when you arch your back. So as we discussed earlier in the first step, you get a flat base, drop back down, come in. It allows you to get a nice arch on your back. Okay, so the next thing I want to talk about is grip. So a lot of people ask me, where should I place my grip on the bar? You know, I've seen people, so let's come in and talk about this, right? So people with long arms should have a little bit of wider grip, maybe like around, maybe in the middle to right here. If you have really long arms and you're a taller person, me personally, I'm a shorter person, my limbs are a little bit shorter, so I have a closer grip. So my grip is usually, bring it back right here. My grip is really close. It's maybe like two pinkies from right here, from the inner part of the ring. So I'm a tricep dominant bencher. So I want my grip to be a little bit closer because I rely on my triceps a lot when it comes to my bench press. But yeah, when it comes to grip, you wanna do what's right for you. If my grip is close, you don't wanna emulate that and then think that that's the best for you. If you have longer arms, your grip's gonna be a little bit wider. Also, when you're gripping the bar, you wanna grip the bar like a death grip. Like you wanna squeeze it, you wanna choke it. But don't think about it like you're killing someone. Just imagine like you're trying to choke the bar. Not like an actual person, the bar. So you're trying to really, really squeeze the bar. You're trying to really just like
Are you trying to choke two necks?
Well, the bar is not that thick. You want to squeeze the hell out the bar. That's the main thing, because when you squeeze the hell out the bar, first of all, it's a safety issue. You don't want to do any death grips like Kelvin. Kelvin likes to do death grips like this. So like he takes his thumb out of the equation and like kind of benches like that. What you want to do is use your thumb, squeeze the hell out of the bar. That's going to help activate your central nervous system and get your body ready to bench and let your body know that, hey, we're about to lift some heavy weight. Okay, guys, so I've been trying to think about how I'm going to demonstrate this next step, and this is the best way I know how to demonstrate it. All right, Kelvin, you ready?
Ah!
All right, you see that, guys? You saw how my back tightened up, or actually, you saw how my shoulder blades touch each other? So, Kelvin, pinch me again. This is for you guys. I'm getting pinched for you guys. Let's do it again. Okay. I think I get it. So this next part is about pinching your shoulder blades together and making sure that you're staying tight. This is gonna make you stay tight and it's gonna protect your shoulders. So let me show you guys what it looks like on the bench. So basically, what I was trying to demonstrate with Kelvin pinching my back is that it's like, act like someone's pinching your back, or act like there's a paper in between your shoulders and you want to keep it together. I like to think about, you know, someone pinching my back, because what your first reaction when someone pinches your back, you're like, basically pinch your shoulder blades together, act like someone's pinching your back, and I'm gonna show you guys what that looks like. So once again, foot placement, push your back, able to arch your back, fall back. Now, you pinch the shoulder blades together. So this is me relaxed, like this, and then now it's like pinching the shoulder blades together, and it creates even more of an arch in my back. So make sure you're pinching the shoulder blades together, and that's gonna help you stay tight and protect your shoulders. Okay guys, so next I wanna talk about breathing. Breathing is, I think, is one of the more underrated things about powerlifting. You think about breathing when you're squatting, you think about breathing whenever you're deadlifting, but some people don't think about breathing whenever it comes to benching, and breathing is really important when it comes to benching. So whenever you take in a big
breath,
okay,
big breath of air.
Whenever you're taking a big breath of air, it helps you keep your core tight, and it also helps you get more pressure inside your body so you're able to lift the weight up. So think about it like this. Whenever you're about to go down, get in a big breath of air and keep it in there. As you go down and you touch your chest or wherever you get your bar placement at, as you touch it, exhale out and use that pressure to help you bring the bar back up. One last thing about breathing is that you want to make sure you get in a new big breath of air after each rep. So rep number one is going to be a big breath of air in itself, and then as you complete rep number one, you're going to get in another deep breath, and then reset, and then do another rep. Okay, so the next thing we want to talk about is tucking the elbows. Now, a way you want to think about it is like someone's tickling you, right? Like someone's tickling your armpits, and what's the thing you want to do? You want to kind of protect, you want to guard the armpits, right? You want to guard the armpits, so you're going to tuck your elbows closer to your body. So someone tickles you, right? Boom, right there. All right, so you're protecting the elbows. I mean, you're protecting the, armpits. So one more time. All right, so we got, this is like flaring your elbows, right? So act like someone's tickling you. Bam, tuck them. So, tuck your elbows. Basically, you're protecting your armpits. So that's my elbows flared, right? But then when someone tickles me, I tuck it, start bringing it closer. So basically act like someone's tickling. Oh. You guys didn't just see that. I didn't just hit my head on the barbell as I'm trying to teach you guys how to bench. You guys did not just see that. So basically what you want to act like, what you want to simulate is someone's tickling your armpits and you're protecting your armpits by tucking your elbows. Tickle, tuck. Tickle, tuck. That's basically what you're trying to think about whenever you're trying to tuck your elbows closer together. Bring it in. So another thing I want to talk about is bar placement. A lot of you guys comment on my videos like, Russell, your bar placement is kind of weird whenever you're benching. So everyone's bar placement is going to be a little bit different. I have like shorter arms and my grip is a lot closer. So whenever I'm benching, the bar is on the top, is on my top ab. It's like right under my nipples, right? So my nipples are right here. This is my nipples. And then the bar is going to be touching right here. So a lot of people's bar placement is a little bit different, right? Maybe their bar placement is right directly on top of the nipple, or it's like in between the nipple and the top ab. My personal bar placement is on the top ab. So everyone's bar placement is gonna be a little bit different. It's about what you're comfortable with and what's gonna help you bench the most weight possible. Okay guys, so how are we gonna incorporate our legs into the bench? So I talked about in step one how we have our feet placed all the way back and grounded and cemented into the floor. You can't have a good bench if you don't have a good foundation. So basically what we're going to do is flex our glutes as we're benching. So your glutes are gonna be flexed the whole time as you're benching, and that's gonna incorporate more of your leg drive. That's gonna make you think about your leg drive a lot more, and that's gonna activate your quads, your glutes, and it's gonna help you bring the weight back up, thus giving you a lot more on your bench press. Okay guys, so now I'm gonna show you how everything looks whenever you incorporate all those tips I gave to you guys. So this is me start to finish whenever I'm bench pressing. So, hope you guys are able to learn something from this. More of a kind of an educational video. So this video is coming to an end. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Like always, if you like this video, please like, comment, share, and subscribe. Get better today. I'm out. You guys thought about squat every day?
do that to my lens.